Most of you have probably heard of the half-full, half-empty example when talking about perspectives. So to start off my talk, I want to do a survey. So when you see half a glass of water, how many of you would say it's half-full? How many of you would say it's half-empty? But did any of you try to dig deeper into the topic and wondered why some people see the glass half full while some see it half empty? Perception, by definition, means a way of regarding facts, situations, and more, and judging their relative importance. Life does not only consist of positive, negative, or neutral events that happen to you, but more importantly, it consists of how you react to them. When you're on your deathbed, looking back at your life, perception will be the one determining what you remember from your memories and how they made you feel. Since I was a child, I would always look around and ask myself, how are all these people interpreting this moment in their head? We would have little visits to Istanbul, and seeing that cosmopolitan environment with such a diversity of people would always leave question marks in my head. Question marks like, which phase of life are these people living in right now? What are they questioning? What are they sure of? What matters for them the most? These question marks increased when I entered fifth grade, when my family and I moved to Libya. There, I went to an international school where our class of 26 students represented 18 different countries. And with that, I got exposed to many different perspectives from such a young age. I started to get answers to these question marks when I entered our first theory of knowledge class. We went to class and we thought that the teacher would introduce the syllabus or something. But he told us to draw the map of the world. Now, this was a rather strange task, and everyone whined about how it wouldn't be accurate, but the teacher told us to do it anyway. When all the maps were drawn, he told us a very interesting fact, that people normally draw their own country larger or more detailed. He then explained the reason for this. Since we look at life from our point of view, we see it the way we learned it. First, we're introduced to our family. We learn about who our mother and father is. Then, slowly but surely, we learn about our community, our nation, and what our cultural identity is. And finally, we learn about our world and start to get the bigger picture. Now, with this, I started to see the similarities among people and, of course, the differences. And I thought to myself, everyone has their own unique perspective. Everyone has their own unique world. And this idea, although it may sound simple, made me think, millions of worlds within one world, millions of perspectives within one community, seeing everything differently. And I came to see that, like this little photo says, reality can be so complex that equally valid observations from different perspectives can appear to be contradictory. Now with this, I started to think about how perspectives were created in the first place. And of course, there are many things that shape one's perception of life, like childhood, where you live, your culture, ethnicity, and much more. But the thing that contributes the most is your conclusions. Conclusions you come to after experiencing something. Assumptions you make according to difficult situations. Lessons you learn from stories that were told to you. All of these and much more add to your collection of conclusions. Those little bits of information you don't know why you know, and those little bits of memories you can't understand why you recall, are all those little bits that make up your perception. So there was this one little memory that I didn't understand why I remembered. When I was in first grade, our teacher grounded us by making us leave late for lunch. And I don't remember what we had done wrong, but I was extremely mad because I remember I hadn't done anything wrong. And 5 minutes before the detention was over, the teacher said, "Sena looks the most sorry out of all the kids, so she has earned the right to leave early for lunch." And with this, I drew the conclusion that if I worry about things enough, then I will finally get what I want. And there are other things that, besides your personal life, that influence your perspective as well. like books you read, movies you see, the music you listen to. Our Turkish literature teacher once told us that even though you forget the characters' names or the plotline of the books you read, you never forget the conclusion you drew out from those books. And with every single conclusion, your perspective develops and you get a better understanding of the world around you. And after coming to some kind of understanding about how perspectives are formed, I started to think about how they reflected upon our lives. And I came to see that if you pay attention to little details about people, you could easily understand this mental window of theirs. I also came to see that with a little effort, we could change this mental window and adapt it to see whatever we want. Now, at this point of the talk, you probably think that I would advise you to adapt your lens to only focus on the positive. But that is a very wrong approach as well, because seeing the positive won't make the negative go away. It will only make you ignorant of your surroundings. So I won't tell you that ignorance is bliss, because it isn't. And I won't tell you to only focus on the positive, because life isn't. But I will tell you to be more open-minded, to be more objective, to think before you react, and to understand before you judge. So be aware of your thoughts, because they determine your conclusions. Be aware of your conclusions, because they determine your perception. And be aware of your perception, because it determines your reality. Always keep in mind that if you change the way you look at things, eventually the things you look at will change. Thank you.